Welcome to the Word Podcast. The Lord God has given us His Word. Let us learn it. Let us live it. Let us rejoice in it. Spread the Word.
Blessings, everybody. This is Dale. Thank you so much for joining with me today on the Word Podcast. We're continuing our examination of the book of Philippians in the third chapter. And remember what was happening here. Paul was encouraging these folks, and he was saying, hey, rejoice in the Lord. The first thing he says is rejoice, but then he tells them to beware. Okay? And so I think that's a good balance with some things right there, okay? We are to rejoice in the Lord day in and day out. In the midst of everything, rejoice in the Lord. Now, not rejoicing for everything, I understand that, but rejoicing in the Lord in the midst of everything. But to beware. Beware of the dogs. Beware of the evil workers. Beware of the false circumcision. Remember that? So he's telling them, watch out for these things. Okay, realize that these things are going to be happening. But then he says, don't put your confidence in the flesh. And he said, if anybody could put their confidence in the flesh, I could. And remember the example he gave him himself, how he was circumcised on the eighth day. He was of the nation of Israel, the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew of the Hebrews, a Pharisee. He'd persecuted the church. So if anybody could rest in what they had done in the flesh, it would have been Paul. But then Paul said this, you know, whatever I had attained or whatever I had, I counted all as loss for the sake of Christ. He said it doesn't compare at all to that, to the surpassing value of knowing Christ Jesus as my Lord. And he says, if I suffer the loss of everything, it's just literally calls it dung. Okay, it's just rubbish, just nothing. So he says, the fact that I know him and the power of his resurrection and that I'm pressing on toward that and the fellowship of his suffering and being conformed to his death, he said, that is far, far superior. And all of this is in order that I may attain to the resurrection from the dead. Again, not to attain it from the positional point of view of attaining salvation. No, 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 no. That's not what he's talking about. What he's talking about is the salvation that he had, okay? The salvation that he has, that this is being worked out. Remember he said that, work out your salvation. Now, chapter 3, verse 12, he continues. And he wants everybody to know this, not that I've already obtained it. Well, already obtained what? Well, the resurrection from the dead. The salvation, yes, he had attained, but not the resurrection from the dead. He said, not that I've already obtained it or have already become perfect. And you say, well, you know, that word always bothers us. It means that to be complete, to come to an end, to bring to an end. He said, it's not that I've already attained all that. He said, I haven't. I haven't come to the end of everything yet. Okay? So he's saying, I have, though, done something. Now listen to this. Not that I've already obtained it or become perfect, but I, are you ready for this? Press on. Yeah. I press on. What does he press on? Press on so that I may lay hold of that for which also I was laid hold of by Christ Jesus. So that gives us the understanding of it. He's saying it's the Lord Jesus Christ who has laid hold of me. It's the Lord Jesus Christ who has saved me. It is by him and him alone that salvation has come into my life. He said, he's the only reason. And I have been laid hold of by him. So therefore, I'm pressing in and I'm pressing on that I may lay hold of that for which I was laid hold of. He said, to obtain this by the power of the Lord Jesus. So we see that from the positional point of view, we have salvation if we're truly saved, but we need to keep pressing on. As a matter of fact, he says that twice in these few verses we're going to look at today. Philippians 3, verse 13, he continues on, brethren, I do not regard myself as having laid hold of it yet, but one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and reaching forward to what lies ahead, I press on toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. So what's he saying here? He's saying, you know, I am a believer. I believe. I've repented. I've confessed. I've called upon the name of the Lord. I am saved is what Paul is saying. But I don't regard myself as having laid hold of all that yet. In other words, I'm not being lazy. I'm not being apathetic about something. I'm not just sitting there saying, okay, I am right before God so I can live like I want to and do what I want to, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. No, no, no. I keep pressing on toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. So what's the prize? What's the goal? The goal and the prize is the upward call. Now, remember the context of what we've seen already in chapters 1, 2, and 3. He's saying, you know, I'd a lot rather be in the presence of God. If he wanted to call me on home right now, that's great. That's wonderful. That is much, much better. He said, but I also know that if I'm left here, that it's better for you because I can continue teaching you. I can continue modeling the kingdom for you. I can do this. He says, but even in the midst of doing what we do for the kingdom in this corporeal existence, in this life, it is a pressing on toward the upward call of God. And that call of God is in Christ Jesus. So notice what we learn here. That's in Christ Jesus thing. We are laid hold by Christ Jesus is he who saves us. We press on and reach out toward the goal that is in Christ Jesus. And that goal is the upward call of the Lord. So listen to verses 15 and 16. We'll be done. Let us therefore, as many as are perfect, have this attitude. In other words, when you're complete, when you're saved, you're positionally right before God, let's have this attitude, okay? And if in anything you have a different attitude, God will reveal that also to you. However, let us keep living by that same standard to which we have attained. And remember, he's been talking about attitude, been talking about how they view some things and how they respond to some things. And he says, you need to have this attitude. And it's actually sort of humorous how he says this. He says, anybody who's complete, anybody who's perfect, anybody has understanding, have this attitude. Have the attitude that Christ Jesus had. Remember, that was the previous thing. Have that attitude. If you have a different attitude, God will reveal that also to you. In other words, if you're wrong, if you're in error, if you don't have the complete understanding of this, then the Lord will reveal this to you. But keep on living by that same standard to which we've attained, the standard of holiness, the standard of righteousness. This is what he is exhorting the body to do. This is the exhortation that we as the body of Christ so need to hear today. Most of us, I fear, who are true believers, sort of have a lackadaisical attitude. We sort of sit back and say, well, I'm hitting my lick for the kingdom of God. I'm doing this, I'm doing that. And there is so much more that the Lord is wanting us to do, not in the flesh, okay? Not by the power of the flesh, but by the power of the Spirit that he's wanting us to do in this life right now. I think that we live very, very limited kingdom existences, and he wants to set us free to do things which we cannot even dream or imagine about. What do you think? Well, take this before the Lord and see what he reveals to you. Again, I'm Dale. I'll see you next time.